And we want to do with a little pan. We are dealing with no pan and so on. So let me deal with a little pan. You understand? Because you know in Carnival, Pan Day. But the problem is, one, I want to first congratulate Pan Trinbago for having the Pan Calypso competition and so on, which started last year and so on. And it seemed to have spawned a lot of calypsos with melodies. The problem is to sing about the pan. Them fellas don't have enough genius to sing about the pan. So you have a lot of pan song that is really pan song and not song of steel band songs. You understand what I'm saying? However, Pan Trinbago must be congratulated because we were going down a dark abyss of self-indulgent pan songs from pan arrangers who were well aware of the shortcomings of the band. Whereas the Calypsonian, who are not really accurate as such with pan and its ability, would pull the pan in a direction, forcing them to get to a certain level of development to be able to play the music. So for that, Pan Trinbago must be congratulated. However, when we come to Panorama, I want to talk about the wanton abuse of freeco, free ticket, storming, and other levels of stupidity which we have generated into over the last few years. And it is now no longer an opportunity for a few stragglers. It is now the norm for people to feel because there's your partner, they had to get free ticket. I do not know who invented complimentary, but I thought complimentaries were given to those people who help you and so on to get a few tickets and wouldn't take up too much of your space, because in anything you're doing, you're selling is space to somebody to see something. However, that is not what complimentary is about. Complimentary is to make sure the artists starve and die so that nobody must pay to go anything. Everything must be free. It's be quality of why we must pay for it and so on. Fine. But as an artist, you cannot be employed in anything else because you're doing the art full time. So you must hit the pavement, beg, borrow, or steal, cook your food on the eternal flame outside the Red House. Because look how much money you spend to put your product there. You must give these Mickey Mouse people freeco. Please go out and buy the tickets for the respective shows so the artists can be paid. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
You like that one, Iwer? Bunji, Raga Soca. Your partner, your father, he has referred to himself now as the current Raga Soca monarch. You going behind him?
Present.
What do you think about that?
You have to come.
Alright, I don't talk.
You don't talk? Mr. KMC, you don't compete no more.
Yeah, I altered the competition.
You're just doing freestyle here, there, and everywhere.
All about.
But you are comfortable with what you have achieved thus far, what, you know, and for your
career. Yeah, man, well, I achieved plenty, you know, in these 2 years here. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm going good.
What advice you have for the other youngsters who are still hardcore into dancehall and haven't tried soakers yet?
Well, you're going on. I don't think right now it has no youth that's still hardcore in dancehall right now.
Everybody
now, after me and Bunji Garlin bus there,
yeah.
A man see what's going on, everybody singing soca.
But you would say soca has been good to you?
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. I know real dancehall men, and every dancehall man I know, does anyone see me say, hey, KMC, I'm a thing, you know.
Yeah.
You understand? Everybody doesn't know what's going on. The people and the youth in Trinidad are ready for the music.
Yeah, okay. And what about you, Bunji? What advice do you have for those youngsters, you know?
Well, all I can tell them is that if they once again in this industry, mm-hmm. Burn your belly. Burn it. Because you're a real thing to get when you see a communist industry.
Would you encourage other people who might be still, you know, borderline in the dance hall to come into the calypso or soca business?
I do encourage nobody against their will, but mm-hmm. I will just tell them, give it a try and you'll see what will happen. I give it a try and you see what happens. And I'm going down the road still.
Mr. Iwa, where's your vibe considering that you have created a space in the dance hall? You have made it twice to Skinner Park in the Calypso semi-final. Get early numbers, I don't know why. You know, would you re-enter the Calypso Monarch and give me the opportunity to?
Right now, it depends on how the song flow when I do my album.
Mm.
You know, if I come up with some songs and the songs end up out there and it's that type of song that will go there, then I'll go there. But I end up going and write new song especially for that show. Because I have a lot of respect for them old boys and them. And when I look at the whole industry, it take a turn from where it used to be before. And I just feel I should leave them fellas and let them fellas eat that food.
Mm-hmm.
So when it comes to Kaiso Fiesta, I will just do a guest appearance and show that the people have a good time and they jump up and they free mm-hmm. themselves up then. But other than that thing, let them fellas them handle that and eat the food.
How
and I want them fellas and them to be grateful too, because we ain't trying to contest the space. So the whole of the space and leave we in the space. It's all right. We go sing half past 4 and 5 o'clock in the party and thing in the morning. You know, we go do that work. But the whole lot of the space now. Don't fight with them.